Let's just get into something else. Yeah, let's just get into something else. All right, so let's see. Anything?
This has been coming out. This has been coming out like a motherfucker. This came out in the podcast today. I wish.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not sure what energies or what things of the past have a restraint on y'all, but the way that God is literally knocking that shit out of your way is preposterous. Like, the way he's clearing a path right now is, like, mind-boggling to me. Like, the way he is, it's like he's creating a path. See, and then, look at this shit here. Look at this shit here. The Six of Pentacles fell on the Eight of Cups. The way he is clearing a path, because this is what you're walking towards. The way he's clearing a path is fucking crazy. That's fucking crazy. The way he is clearing a path. Oh my gosh. The way. This fell on this. This give me this. This give me him. This is him. This is him, and this is how he ends. This is him, and this is how he ends. Look how he looking to the left or the right, whatever. But look how he looking. The moon looking down this way, and he looking that way. And y'all remember when I had, this was a while ago. Y'all might not remember, but y'all remember how I was on live one day and we was reading the Bible about the, matter of fact, hold on, it's 12:06, the Bible, the verse of the day. That's what I've been waiting on. But y'all remember when I read in the Bible about the king that left and he had gave all his servants, like, you know, some coins or some money or something, and they didn't do what they needed to do? And he took the money that one servant made and gave it to the other ones. That's what that gave me. Look, cause his hands is open, but the hands is coming here, and then look at the scale in the hands. Okay, so if you look at this from my point of view, right, he's given with the left hand, or maybe it might be the right. No, that's the left. That's the left. If we look at it from our way, that's the left. He's given something with the right hand and the left hand. And the right hand has the scale. Y'all see that? Both these people got red capes on. What the fuck is he in? My hands itching. No, sorry. It came out like this. Four of Cups is not seeing something, not taking something. Temperance is balance, but y'all, the way this path is being cleared, this is fucking crazy. And then the fact that I tried to speak on what's going on at the new moon and the full moon, the new moon and the full moon, and that shit wasn't going for it. I was trying to tell y'all something major, and they wasn't going for it. They just wasn't going for it. I really was. I was on to something, too. And I know I was. I've never had my lip jump like that. That was wild. Look at the Empress. Look at the motherfucking Empress in the Three of Cups. Look at that. You know, Libra season is going to be a celebration, but boy, 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 I was about to tell y'all something so fucking major, and I knew I was onto something. I'm telling y'all, when I light that blunt, I be going places that the Lord be like, girl, what is you doing over here? Ariana, what are you doing here? Oh, very much so. Very much so. People is really struggling too. And the sad part about it is they've been forewarned for a minute. Like, it's gonna seem new to everybody else, but it's not new. This is not new at all. There's nothing going on that's new. They've known this for a while. Yeah, that shit was weird, though. You know what? Never mind. If you heard the dates that I was talking about, you already know. But if you didn't hear the dates I was talking about, just wait. Because it started with Halloween. Ooh. You know that I hear that part in my song. I hear that part in the song with R. Kelly. He was like, I don't want to hurt nobody, but it's something that I must confess. Somebody has to confess something. Something's going to be confessed. I don't know. I'm in between. I'm on the defense. I don't feel like Scorpio season's going to be bad for some of us. And others of us. I feel like a lot of people going to be scared. Oh, it's 12 o'clock. Oh, my God. And the verse of the day for today. Now today is Thursday. Today's Venus goes into Libra. Venus goes into Libra today. And the verse of the day says, and hey, let's go ahead and deposit the check in the account, shorty, because I'm that bitch. Okay, Libra season. I told y'all, a lot of these bitches out here is not that girl. I'm that girl. Okay, I'm that bitch. Peace. From John 14:27, it says, peace is what I leave with you. What was the card we had at the bottom of the deck of today's reading? I mean, yesterday's reading, ending yesterday's reading. Peace, Jesus Christ, it is my own peace that I give you. I do. And then the Six of Pentacles was just in here as he was giving somebody something. I did not give it as the world does. Do not be worried and upset. Do not be afraid. Oh, my ears is itching. Glory to God. I literally just read that shit. Peace is what I give to you. Come on, man. You have to stop it. God is showing out right now. The Lord is showing out right now. This is crazy. This is preposterous. Damn. Did I wait too long? It's probably asleep. Damn, that's crazy. That's fucking crazy. That's fucking crazy. That's fucking crazy. That is fucking crazy. Peace is what I leave with you. It is my own peace that I give you. I do not give it as the world does. I do not give it as the world does. Do not be worried. Do not be worried and upset. Do not be afraid. Wait a minute. I could have sworn I just seen that somewhere. I just seen that somewhere. Okay, hold on. Didn't I tell y'all that Ceres and Cyrus enters Virgo today? With the nurturing Ceres and service oriented in Virgo, it's important to find time and energy to take care of ourselves and attend to our only healing rather than tending to the needs of others. It says, Jesus, the way to the Father. The Eight of Cups, he's walking somewhere. And didn't I tell y'all that God was creating you a path? Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. I know I be fucking on this shit, bro. I be on this shit like Bill Nye the motherfucking science guy, bro. Look at this shit. Jesus, the way to the Father. Do not be worried and upset, Jesus told them. Believe in God and believe in also me. There are many rooms in my Father's house, and I am going to prepare a place for you. I will not tell you this if it were not so. And after, didn't I just say he was making a path for you to get to the thing or what he was going to give you? I will not tell you as if it were not so. After I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you myself. So that you will be where I am. You know the way that leads to the place where I'm going. The moon. Okay. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way to get there? And y'all remember I was telling y'all about in the darkness that the moon only comes out in the darkness and that's your light, but the moon, the darkness would be considered your intuition and the sun would be considered your ego. So when the lights are on, you move in a way of that what you can see. And then when the lights are off, you move on to things that you can't see, which is 2 Corinthians 4:18, which is the Bible verse that's tattooed on my left arm with the clock here of 444. And 444 is your angels, but it's also stability. Okay, here we go. Jesus answered to him, I am the way, the truth. And today we got the truth. I need to go rewatch that live from earlier because Lord knows a bitch is on to something. I am the truth and the life, and no one goes to the Father except by me. Now that you have known me, he said to them, you know my, blah, blah, blah. You will know my Father also, and now you do know him and you have seen him. Philip said, Lord, show us the Father. That is all we need. Jesus answered, for a long time I have been with you all, yet you do not know me. Philip, however, whoever has seen me has seen the Father. Why then do they say, show us the Father? Do you not believe, Philip, that I am the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I have spoken to you, Jesus said to his disciple, do not come from me. They come from my Father. And what was the Bible verse yesterday about who am I going to send to be my messenger? And he said, me. Oh, this is getting crazy. The words that I have spoken to you, Jesus said to his disciples, they do not come from me. The Father who remains in me does his own work. Believe me when I say that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. And if not, believe of the things I do. I am telling you the truth. Those who believe in me will do what I do. Yes, they will do. And then as I was telling y'all about that damn Zoom the private Zoom that I did, I told them to write down, what would Jesus do? That was on September 25th. Something is going to happen around October 25th. Because that wasn't on the 25th. Was that? What's today? Damn. Hold on. Today the 28th. That was on the 25th. That was Sunday. The full moon was Sunday, right? I don't fucking know. My fucking days is all whack. But either way it goes, I told them to write down, what would Jesus do? And here we are with the Lord saying, with Jesus saying, do as I do. Excuse me. Thank you. And I will do whatever you ask for in my name, so that the Father's glory will be shown through the Son. So that the Father's glory will be shown through the Son. The Son came out in our reading today of the first house. It's illuminating who you truly are. How does Jesus and the Lord see you? If you ask me for anything in my name, I will do it. The promise of the Holy Spirit. If you love me, you will obey my commandments. I will ask the Father and he will give you another helper. And what did it say today about them introducing somebody as an angel introduction? Who will stay with you forever? He, like the fucking adjustment bureau, somebody that will stay with you forever. That's your higher self. That's your spirit guides. He is the spirit who reveals the truth about God. The world cannot receive him because it cannot see him or know him. But you know him because he remains with you and is in you. When I go, you will not be left all alone. And then the other day we had got the card about you never being alone because you now have started to welcome your spiritual realm. Venus going into Libra today is definitely giving me, here you go. And today is Thursday, which is Jupiter. And then we got Jupiter in today's reading. It's definitely giving me, it's yours. This is all like coming full circle of what the fuck that I said in my podcast yesterday. And I completed my download in the fucking podcast. So that wasn't the issue. But it's just the fact of like, I did the podcast and I wasn't going to come on live. And they was like, go live because we want you to do Daily Glitter. So I did Daily Glitter or whatever. And then it's like today, because I've been preparing everybody for when Venus goes into Libra or whatever. Because when Venus goes into Libra, it's I'm telling you, it's living a life of luxury. Okay. You're gonna see who's that girl, who's not that girl, but you're gonna see who's that girl through God, okay? And the people that they're not that girl through God. Okay. And it's 12:22. And The fact that today talks about like when I was telling about like God creating you a path and it's like as long as you listen to whatever the path is, it's like you won't have a problem or whatever, right? And so the fact that we getting all into this and then it's saying the things of glory through the Sun, and the Sun is in Libra and Venus is in Libra. So as the Sun is in Libra and Venus is in Libra, it's definitely highlighting the glory. And y'all know I'm always saying glory to God. When I go, you will not be left alone. I will come back to you. In a little while, the world will see me no more. In a little while, the world will see me no more, but you will see me. And then it's funny because at the beginning of, it wasn't the beginning, my bad. When I did that live that Thursday, before Libra season, when I got my hair done in that yellow dress, I remember telling the Miss Crazy that the things that the Lord isn't in, that people swore that God was in. And somebody was like, oh, that was kind of cocky of you to say of what the Lord isn't in. I was like, if y'all can't see what the Lord is not in, that makes me scared. And that's the same thing I posted on TikTok. The TikTok that I posted of that clip of me in the yellow dress, and I was saying how y'all are making a choice, and it's not a coincidence. It's because of the fact of, like, if you can't, that's the live I'm talking about. If you can't see that God is not within that stuff, then that makes me nervous about you. You know what I'm saying? Because he says, in a little while, the world will see me no more, but you will see me because I live. You will also live. When that day comes, you will know that I am in my Father, and that you are in me just as I am in you. Those who accept my commandments, and we read the Ten Commandments 2 weeks ago, and I told y'all that they were very serious and that people needed to fucking pay attention to the fucking Ten Commandments. And thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not listen to the person that's not. And the fact that he said that the day would come, and I told y'all it was like Judgment Day, we all heard it. And when I was saying about calling all the steppers to the front, get ready for the show. The ones who accept my commandments and obey them are the ones who love me. My Father loves those who love me. I too will love them and reveal myself to them. Judas, not Judas Iscariot, said, I don't know what the fuck that word is, but the devil said, no, I don't know. Judas, whoever this is, said, Lord, how can it be that you will reveal yourself to us and not to the world? Jesus answered him, those who love me will obey my teaching. My Father will love them, and my Father and I will come to them and live with them. Those who don't love me do not obey my teaching. And the teaching you have heard is not mine, but comes from the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am still with you. The Helper, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything. The Helper will teach you everything and make you remember that all that I had told you. Peace is what I leave with you. And that's what we talked about today. Okay. And then he said, that was the verse of the day. Then he said, you heard me say to you, I am leaving, but I will be back. I am leaving, but I will be back. If you love me, you would be glad that I'm going to the Father, for he is greater than I. I have told you this now before it all happens, so that when it does happen, you will believe. I cannot talk much longer because the ruler of this world is coming. The ruler of this world is coming. He has no power over me, but the world must know that I love the Father. That is why I do everything that he commands. Come, let us go from this place. Come, let us go from this place. The six of fucking pentacles came. No, sorry. The eight of cups came out, right? The eight of cups came, and then the six of cups came, which is the past, okay? But this is also like the kid energy of following directions. And then the tower came out, right? So then after the tower came out, come from this place because the ruler is coming. And if you watch the because he said, no, the emperor, sorry, no, scratch the emperor, I'm sorry, it's the tower. Because he said, the ruler of this world has no power over me. The tower, if you remember in the Adjustment Bureau, the hammer was Thomas, and he was one of the oldest angels or the oldest agents or whatever the fuck he was. Jesus, the real vine. Hold on, because we just had the six of wands. I don't know where the fuck the six of wands went. Oh, shit. Not they made me clear the direction from what I was going to say to this direction. We still going down the rabbit hole, which is crazy. Because whatever the fuck is happening next month and the month after that does not want to be told right now. So let me just focus on what needs to be told right now. I am the real vine, and my Father is the gardener, queen and king of pentacles. He breaks off every branch that does not bear fruit, and he prunes every branch that does bear fruit so that it will be clean. And what did I say about that purification happening after that fucking, after you coming into your animal instincts? You have been clear already by the teaching that I have given you. Remain united to me. Union, that four wands energy that we've been talking about, which is the stability energy that came out in the reading today. Remain united to me and I remain united to you. A branch cannot bear fruit by itself. It can do so only if it remains in the vine. In the same way, you cannot bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine and you are the branches. Those who remain in me and I in them will bear much fruit. For you can do nothing without me. Those who do not remain in me are thrown out like a branch to dry up. And it's funny because the Ace of Wands comes to mind. It's funny because on the bottom of the deck was the Three of Pentacles and then the Ace of Wands, the branch. Okay, here we go. Some branches are gathered up and thrown. And then in today's reading, we got the Seven of Wands, where all the wands were against the person. And then we had the Six of Wands afterward, and all the wands were on the ground but one. Some branches are gathered up and thrown into the fire where they are burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, then you will ask for anything you wish and you shall have it. I told y'all Libra season has something to do with, like, every wish was your command. Every wish was their command. Like, they'll just give it to you. And then I told y'all that I watched. Oh, no, I didn't. Sorry. I was on the phone with somebody. My bad. I had told them that it was crazy because the other night I was, I couldn't sleep or whatever. And I was on Tubi. You know, Tubi be having ghetto ass movies. But they had this movie called 16 Wishes. And it's this movie where this girl on her 16th birthday, she wrote down this list, and basically her, like, fairy godmother or like her spirit guide or whatever came, and every time she blew out a candle, a wish would come true. Now, what the moral of the story was, the fact of that some of the wishes that she had wished were bullshit. She did it out of ego or whatever. So you got to be careful what you wish for, because then she wished she could go back. And then by the time that she got to the end of, like, realizing that, you know what I'm saying, you got to be careful what you wish for, she blew out a candle to start the day over and started showing more gratitude to people, start being more loving and caring to people. So instead of her being irritated with her parents taking a picture of her, she was like, thank you, I love you guys so much, I can't wait to eat the breakfast and all this stuff. And then she had, like, this stack of money or whatever, and she was going to buy some dumb shit with it or whatever. And, she decided to give the money to her brother because she had saw that her brother in the future is going to be a musician. So she decided to invest in her brother. Like, she decided to put the energy back out there so she could receive it. So then when she started the day over, it was this girl that used to have beef with her. They've been beefing since third grade. She finally went to her and was like, what's the problem? Like, what's the issue that you have with me or whatever? And the girl was like, you really don't know what happened. And she was like, no, what happened? And she was like, in the third grade, you stole my best friend. Hey, Pooh, what's up? She was like, in the third grade, you stole my best friend. And she didn't remember it that way. That's why I was trying to tell y'all, there are some people that's going back and they didn't see it that way. Like, they're seeing things from a different perspective to come back and make amends with you, to apologize. They're doing what Jesus would do. That's something Jesus would do. So she went back and, the girl told her what she did. And she was like, you know, I'm really sorry about that. Like, I really do apologize about that. And she was like, you do? Like, you really do? She was like, yeah. She was like, I didn't know. You know what I'm saying? Like, she was like, I didn't know that that's what happened or whatever. And she was like, you know, I didn't know that that affected you. Like, I didn't know. She basically was like, I stole your best friend. She was like, yeah. Like, and that girl had been harboring on to that resentment since third grade. These bitches is 16 now. Like, that bitch held on to that shit from the third grade. That's why that Six of Cups is here. If the Eight of Cups are walking from the past. Oh, Lord, I'm telling you. We be on the motherfucking something in this damn life. So, in the thing or whatever. So, one of her wishes was to beat the girl, like the girl she was beefing with. One of her wishes was to beat her. So the girl was running for a student body president, and due to her wish, it knocked the girl out, and so she won. But in reality, her best friend, the guy best friend that she had, he actually wanted to be student body president. He actually had the passion and the drive to be it, and she took it out of ego. So after she restarted the day over, and she didn't even realize that he looked at her in so much awe and put her on a pedestal, and he had called her out on her shit, and he was like, you know, you different now that you did all this shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you got all the wishes that you wanted, and you switched up because you too busy trying to be, you know what I'm saying? You too busy trying to be in front of somebody. You too busy trying to boost your ego about somebody. Like, you not doing this shit with, you know, good intent. Like, this is no longer, like, you making your wishes come true. This is you trying to do shit on some up shit. This is what Jesus means when he says, remain, I have, remain in me. Yeah, it's on Disney Channel. It's called 16 Wishes. It says, those who do not remain in me are thrown out like a branch and to dry out. And she had made a wish that she wanted people to stop treating her like a child. They treat her like an adult. So basically, when people started treating her like an adult, she went from 16 to being an adult. So she tried to go back to high school. They threw her out of high school. She tried to live with her parents. Her parents, like, you 18 now, threw her in an apartment. She had to pay for the apartment by herself. Like, you just got to be careful what you wish for. So the fact that movie came on, and like I said, the boy looked at her in awe, and he really wanted to be with her. Like, he really did love her type shit. It was weird. Like, and he didn't really see her as a friend no more. He saw her to be together, but she was so busy worrying about other things, she didn't even see things right in front of her face or what the fuck was going on. And it's crazy because yesterday I was talking, and y'all know that High School Musical thing when she was like, it's hard to believe that I couldn't see that you were always right beside me. That's the energy. And it's like, this feeling's like no other. I want you to know I never had someone who loves me like you do, the way you do. Jesus, okay? Let's use these songs as Jesus, okay? And so then, you know what I'm saying? She finally go back in the right energy or whatever. You do, you like it. That water good as fuck. So then she does it or whatever, and she goes back and she does the day the right way. She ends up coming in union with him. You know what I'm saying? They fall in love. And he was like, what about the wish? And she was like, I got everything that I wished for. She made up with the girl. Her brother, she invested in her brother for him to be a musician. Like, it was so much energy being, you know what I'm saying, like, given and received. So her making up with the girl, they had their birthday parties together. Huge birthday parties. Her giving up student body president gave him the opportunity to be student body president. You dig what I'm saying? Like, she sacrificed what she could have, because at 12 o'clock, whatever she wished for, she could keep. So if she stayed in this adult life, she was going to have to keep it. She got the Mustang that she wanted, she was going to keep it or whatever. But we realized that we got to be careful what we wish for. Because what you wish for might not be what, you know what I'm saying, might not be what you truly want. And that's why I told you, I don't care how high up I ever get. I don't give a fuck how famous I get. I'm still going to be a very down-to-earth bitch. Because I ain't get none of this shit without God, okay? Even when a bitch didn't have two pennies to rub together. You dig what I'm saying? The Lord gave me three nickels. You see what I'm saying? So when Venus is in Libra, and we're in John right now, okay? With Venus being in Libra, and they talking about the branches, okay? And the Ace of Wands keeps coming up. It's definitely giving me, you need to be careful what you wish for. Because it is going to come true if you continue to remain in a WWJD type of energy. And when I told them about the WWJD type of energy, that also meant of how people treat you. Do you think Jesus will let people talk to you fucking crazy? Do you think Jesus will let people beat on you and abuse you? Do you think Jesus will let people manipulate you? Do you think Jesus would do that? Because if you think Jesus would do that, we need to talk to Jesus about what you think. Because Jesus wouldn't allow that. Okay? And that is something really big that y'all need to pay attention to, because this is what I mean when I tell y'all that, like, people gonna pull up on some shit like, oh, hey, what's up? You know what I'm saying? Woo, doo, woo, doo, woo, shink, da, dink, da, dink. And it's like, hold up, my boy. The Lord wouldn't allow somebody like you to be around me. You see what I'm saying? So he says, if you remain in me, then you will ask for anything you wish and you shall have it. My father's glory is shown by your bearing much fruit. And in his way, you become my disciples. I love you just as the Father loves me. Remain in my love. Venus is the planet of love. And it's the planet of self-worth. And the fact that Venus is in Libra and Libra rules partnerships, you need to remain in a partnership with the Lord and the Jesus, our Savior. Okay. All right now. I love you as I love you just as the Father loves me, remain in love. If you obey my commands, you will remain in my love. Them 10 commandments that I told y'all, pay attention, because people is going to try to revise them 10 commandments like that ain't what the Lord says, and I don't agree. I don't agree. We read the 10 commandments on live one day. It's no need for me to read them again. If you need to go read the commandments, you need to go into the Bible and read the commandments, because this is not a game. Because I'm telling y'all, while Venus is in Libra, the way people going to act, they're going to try to revise what the Bible said about the commandments and thou shalt not steal and thou shalt not kill and thou shalt not listen to somebody that is not the Lord. They're going to try to revise it. I can feel it in my spirit. People going to try to, you know what I'm saying, like, that's where that imposter syndrome was coming up about, like, all those frauds and fake pages and shit like that. That's why that shit going to get big, you know what I'm saying, because they praying on y'all, okay? I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. My commandment is... And we finna read the commandments here, Jesus? Oh, Lord. See, the world's hatred. I told you it was a deception and envy. They praying on you. Okay, my commandment is this: love one another. And I keep telling you about loving thy neighbor. Love one another just as I love you. The greatest love you can have for your friends is the partnership is to give your life for them. Wait a minute. When he says to give your life for him, you still don't need to be suffering. You still don't need to be sacrificing your peace. Okay, the Jesus wouldn't let you do that. And you are my friends if you do what I command. I do not call you servants anymore, because servants do not know what their master is doing. Instead, I call you friends, the partnership with the Lord, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, I chose you. Didn't I tell y'all that this was gonna be the golden era, the golden child era? This is it. He chose you and appointed you to go bear much fruit, the kind of fruit that endures. Oh, my nose is itching. And so that the Father will give you whatever you ask of him in my name. This then is what I command to you. Love one another. Venus is in Libra. Libra rules partnerships. If the love don't have longevity, obedience, vitality, and evolution, they don't fucking love you. The world's hatred. This is when I tell y'all, if y'all cross Jesus, I know y'all would cross me. That's why if I seen it in a dream, I don't give a fuck. This is all coming to full circle what I said earlier. If y'all cross Jesus, you know that I know you gonna cross me. And if Jesus had the insight to know who was the person who's gonna cross him, and he said, one of you are going to betray me tonight, you got to know you are the one that will betray me and you have to go. Okay? They got to go. If the world hates me, just remember that it has hated me first. If the world hates you, just remember that it has hated me first. If you belong to the world, then the world would love you as its own. But I choose you from this world, and you do not belong to it. That is why the world hates you. Okay. Remember what I have told you. Slaves are no greater than their master. If people persecuted me, they will prosecute you too. If they obey my teaching, they will obey yours too. But you have to know how you want to be treated yourself, your own morals and values. That's what Jesus was telling us in this teachings. Your teachings are your morals and your values. Jesus always led with integrity, good heart and good intent. That was a moral and value for him. Okay. But They will do all this to you because you are mine, for they do not know the one who sent me. They would not have been guilty of sin if I had not come and spoken to them. They would not have been guilty of sin if I had not come and spoken to them. Because I said, what would Jesus do? Jesus wouldn't do that. Mm-hmm. As it is, they no longer have any excuse for their sin. As I just told y'all, that it is a choice. You are making poor decisions. Jesus Christ, it is not a coincidence of what the fuck is going on to you. It's not a coincidence what the fuck you're going through. It is not a coincidence the people that's fallen away. You know what you did. By the Heavenly Father above, you know what you did. You chose to do that shit. And if Saturn is motherfucking going direct, with Venus being in Libra, Saturn ass is watching y'all motherfuckers. So y'all better calm down, because Pluto also goes direct next week. And I'm trying to tell y'all, watch that shit, because you doing stuff that you know you ain't got no business doing. And in Libra season, if it's all about the inner child, you better act like you got some sense. You better get your act together, because you're a big kid now, remember? And since you're a big kid now, big kids have bigger responsibilities. Big kids know how to act. Big kids know how to be big kids. So therefore, I don't want to hear it. You're choosing to do this, and I don't want to hear it. Because even Jesus said you don't have an excuse for the things that you've done. Even Jesus said, you don't have an excuse for the things that you're doing. There are people that are choosing these things. I mean, one foot in front of the other, choosing to walk down a path of bullshit. Jesus help us. Lord, have mercy. It is really bothering me too. Okay, hold on. Whoever hates me hates my father too. That's why I've been trying to tell people, if you don't like me, you need to take that up with the Lord, because that's crazy. Okay? They would not have been. Oh no, sorry, my bad. Damn. Oh. They would not have been guilty of sin if I have not done among them the things that have no one else have ever did. As it is, they have seen what I did, and they hate me. And my father. These people hate what the Lord is doing. But see, Jesus didn't do that. And that's exactly what I do. You talking about, I can't believe God would make me go through this. What do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? This, however, was bound to happen so that what is written in their law may come true. What is written in their law may come true. Because you know what the law is? Karma. You know what the law is? Karma. It may come true. Watch what you do. Watch what you say. They hated me for no reason at all. The helper will come, the spirit who reveals the truth about God and who comes from the Father. I will send him to you from the Father, and he will speak about me. And you too will speak about me, because you have been with me from the very beginning. I will send the helper. And I told y'all, the Lord told me to wear all white today. May the Lord be with me and cover me during this time, because I'm trying to tell you, I was on my way to tell y'all some shit about something, and then the devil started knock, knock, knocking. And I said, nope. I'm going to be quiet, because I felt that was the Lord saying, be quiet. And it's funny that the left lip thumped, and that's about somebody destroying your reputation. So I just want to let you know right now, two things to show, one thing I know. The Lord don't play by me, so you better watch yourself. Watch yourself. If you know you in here doing some weird shit that Jesus wouldn't do, watch yourself. Because everybody in here is highly protected. Amen. All right, now back to what we was talking about. I have told you this so that you will not give up your faith. You will be expelled from the problems, and the time will come when those who kill you will think that by doing this, they are serving God. Mm-hmm. People will do these things to you because they have not known either the Father or me. But I have told you this so that when the time has come for them to do these things, you remember what I told you. What is everything that I told y'all just before about watching people? So don't act like I didn't tell you. The works of the Holy Spirit. I did not tell you these things at the beginning, for I was with you. But now I am going to who sent me. Yet none of you ask, where am I going? And now that I have told you, your hearts are full of sadness. But I'm telling you the truth. It is better for you that I go away, because if I do not go, the helper will not come to you. Oh my God. And I said that they was done holding our hand. They was finna get stricter. So you didn't have to pay attention. What book is this? The Bible. That spirit was gonna get stricter on us. I think that was the I'm a Big Kid Now podcast that I did. We are reading from the Bible, honey. Yeah, we are reading from the Bible, honey. No, I stand corrected. This is from Get Your Act Together podcast that I did on the 17th of September. Now that the truth is. But if I do go away, then I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will prove to the people of the world that they are wrong about sin and about what is right and about God's judgment. They are wrong about sin because they do not believe in him. They are wrong about what is right because I am the Father and you will not see me anymore. And they are wrong about judgment because the ruler of the world has already been judged. I have much more to tell you, but now it would be too much for you to bear. When, however, the Spirit comes who reveals the truth about God, he will lead you into all the truth. He will not speak on his own authority. He will speak of what he hears and tell you and will tell you of things to come. He will give me glory. As I'm always saying, glory to God. He will give me glory because he will take what I say and tell it to you. All that my Father has is mine, and that is why I said that the Spirit will take what I give him and tell it to you. What I give him, the downloads that I'm receiving to give to you. Glory to God. Sadness and gladness. In a little while, you will not see me anymore, and in a little while later, you will see me. Some of his disciples asked amongst themselves, what does this mean? He tells us that in a little while we will not see him, and then a little while later we will see him. And he also says, it is because I'm going to the Father. What does it mean, a little while mean? We do not know what he's talking about. Jesus knew that they wanted to question him. So he said to them, I said, in a little while you will not see me, and then a little while later you will see me. Bless me. Is this what you're asking about amongst yourselves? I'm telling you the truth. You will cry and weep, but the world will be glad. You will be sad, but your sadness will turn into gladness. When a woman is about to give birth, she is sad because her hour of suffering. When a woman is about to give birth, when a woman is about to give birth, because her hour of suffering has come. But when the baby is born, she forgets her suffering because she is happy that a baby is being born into the world. That is how it is with you. Now you are sad, but I will see you again, and your hearts will be refilled with gladness, the kind of gladness that no one can take away. I told you they was clearing off a motherfucking path. I told you that they was clearing off a path. And then with the Venus being the heart chakra, and then the kid energy, it's like a burst of the heart. But that's what you went through during Virgo season to release all that shit off your heart. That's why everybody's heart was, thank y'all. That's why everybody's heart was opening up. When that day comes, you will not ask for anything. I'm telling you the truth. The Father will give you whatever you ask for in my name. Until then, you may not have asked for anything in my name. Ask. The key word today has been ask. Ask. A-S-K. Ask. 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 Ask for my help. Ask for guidance. I said, if you need anything, ask. It all starts with a prayer. That's why I've been trying to tell y'all to save them worthless prayers. Pray for things that actually you need. Ask God to replace things. Ask God to remove things. Ask God to make a way. Ask God to pave a way. Quit talking about begging God for shit. He don't do it. He tired of doing that. Why do you think he needs to? Why do you think God needs your prayer out of desperation? Why do you think God needs your prayer out of desperation? Is that the only time you think you can call on that you should call on the Lord? Is that a desperation? Why do you pray out of desperation? Why do you think God needs that prayer? God don't need that prayer of desperation. You over there begging and shit. God don't need that. You should have asked for help when you needed help. Now you want to ask out of desperation. You got 24 hours in a day. 24 hours in a day. And you pick at the time of desperation to ask for the Lord? Don't you find that a little preposterous? Victory of the Lord. I have used figures of speech to tell you these things, but the time will come when I will not use figures of speech, but I will speak to you plainly about the Father. When that day comes, you will ask him in my name. I do not say that I will ask him on your behalf, for the Father himself loves you. He loves you because you love me and have believed that I came from God. I did come from the Father, and I came into the world, and now I'm leaving the world, going to the Father. Then his disciples said to him, you are speaking plainly without using figures of speech. You see, I told y'all Virgo season, I was going to be more direct. I wasn't going to be, you know what I'm saying? Y'all know I'm big on analogies because I feel like that's the easiest way to teach people. Because, you know what I'm saying? If I just came out here directly speaking about shit, you'd be like, girl, what the fuck is you talking about? But you see how now we're being very direct. Do you think God needs your prayers of desperation? Come on now. We know now that you know everything. You do not need to have someone ask you questions. This makes us believe that you came from God. People don't question me. They just ask questions for answers. They don't question what I tell them. You know, that's one thing that I was in the bathroom and I was doing my hair the other day. And I thought about that shit. It's just like, y'all must really know that. Like, y'all must peep a real nigga when y'all see a real nigga. Because the way people, you know what I'm saying? I done called out a lot of people, you know what I'm saying? And I don't care, you know what I'm saying? You're not going to beat my ass. But I realized that ain't nobody ever tried to step toe-to-toe and try to call Big Homie out, you know? And I realized that, you know why? It's because I only speak the truth of what the Lord has told me. So if you want to argue with me, that means you arguing with the Lord. So you want to argue with God? You let me know. Because I realized that, you know what I'm saying? I done called out everybody, and I don't give a fuck, you know what I'm saying? And because it's the truth. You need to know the truth. My nose is itching. And I realized that's how God kind of set it up. Everybody that questioned me, the only reason why you're questioning me is because the information that I gave you went right over your head. So you don't have the mental capacity to even understand where we are and what we're talking about. So therefore, your questioning me doesn't even matter because you don't even know where we are. You know what I mean? And I realized that. I really did. And I had to thank God for that. I had to thank God for that. I couldn't even take credit for that. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I am that bitch and I'm the face, but the Lord is the voice and the Lord gave me this gift. And I got to give God for that. Cause I'm telling y'all, nobody's ever come toe to toe with me about anything I've ever said. I don't care what they've done. Even if you did it subliminally, they never done it. And I realized that that's a gift from God. God does that. God uses me as the voice. And I just thought that was such a beautiful thing because there's so many people in this world that God don't speak to them. God don't speak to you. You know what I'm saying? God don't speak to you. You know what I'm saying? And you can always tell the people that the Lord don't speak through because, you know, you can always rebuttal something that they've said. You can always find a loophole of, that wasn't right. You know what I'm saying? I realize that about God's people when the Lord is speaking because you can't really find no loopholes. See what I'm saying? You really can't tell me, you know what I'm saying, that I'm wrong. You can't really tell me, you know what I'm saying? You might not agree, but bitch, oh well, you don't have to agree with what I said, but it's the truth. You see what I'm saying? I realize that about God's people. God's people, he seems to make us so intellectually understanding for people that there's nothing, like, a real nigga's a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? A real nigga's a real nigga. You know what I'm saying? If you real, trust me. People will peep that you real. You know what I'm saying? You don't got to be a pastor. You don't got to be, you know what I'm saying? Like, the Lord's words are the Lord's words. Regardless of, that's what I've been trying to tell y'all. Stop judging people for who they are. Stop judging people for how you see them. Because if you know the truth and you real recognize real, you know what I'm saying? Then you know that that's the Lord talking. That's why when Jesus kept telling them, why don't y'all believe that y'all already seen God? Why don't y'all already believe that y'all have already seen God? You needed to see the figure of the Lord to know that that person is the Lord. See, God is within you. And it's funny because the other day in the verse of the day, not yesterday, the day before yesterday, it was Hold on, wait. Where we at? 16. We have John 16, verse 31. Okay, hold on. I wanna read this real quick. No. The verse of the day. The verse of the day was Tuesday on Mars Day, on the day of Mars. In view of all this, what can we say? If God is for us, who can be against us? Glory to God. Who can be against us if God is with us? So therefore, if this ain't double confirmation, on Tuesday was Mars Day and Thursdays is Jupiter, both days of fire, you can't be touched as long as you're walking with the Lord. You see what I'm saying? You can't really rock with God's people like that. You dig what I mean? And if this don't give you a clear understanding of what Venus and Libra is going to be, because I told y'all, calling all the steppers to the front. When I said that, that was God's people coming to the front. And you ain't going to be able to battle with them, argue with them, go back and forth with them. Because you know one thing I don't do? Y'all know I don't go back and forth with nobody. I'm either going to block the shit out you or I'm just going to look at you. Because what are you arguing with? You trying to argue with the Lord? That don't you think that's highly embarrassing for yourself? Okay. And I just had that realization the other day. So, and the fact that Jesus put this in the Bible, or and it was in John, it just makes sense of what he meant by that. Even the pastors, and don't bring up T.D. Jakes. I understand you have an opinion, but T.D. Jakes is a man of the Lord. I don't want to hear it. But that pastor that put his hands on that lady, and you over there trying to teach about the word of God. Yeah, God don't talk to you. God don't talk to you. And he keeps showing you that he don't talk to you through every incident that go on in that church. Every incident that go on in that church, it shows. It shows that the Lord don't talk to you. The Lord don't talk to you. It shows on Christian TikTok, and it be showing in these churches. It shows the Lord really don't talk to you, because it always seems to be some shit going on in your environment. Same thing with people that's not, you know what I'm saying, they don't got to be in the church, but just people in general. I told y'all, people are losing their shit. People are just doing whatever. And those of us that are just trying to just make peace and have fun and stay in the energy of love every day, we don't seem to be worried. We don't seem to be worried. I don't stress. Stress makes you ugly. Okay, I'm still getting carded to buy scratch-offs. Stress makes you ugly, baby. We're doing very well over here. If you're stressed, it's because you're not with the Lord. And that's the problem right there. Okay? Hold on. He says, you do not need to have someone ask questions. This makes us believe that you came from God. So you can't question God's people. Jesus answered them, do you believe now? The time is coming and it's already here. When all of you will be scattered, each of you to your own home, and I will be left alone. But I am not really alone, because the Lord, the Father is with me. I have told you this so that you will have peace by being united with me. The world will make you suffer, but be brave. I have defeated the world. When he says things about the world will make you suffer, this is that energy of that devil energy that's all up in this damn world. Pluto being in retrograde the last 5 months was trying to defeat you. That's why the last 2 months it got so heavy. The Lord said, I got to put y'all up for protection. I need y'all to be obedient. Okay. When the accountability threshold was passed in Cancer season and we saw the sacrifices people were making for themselves, Jesus Christ, God says, I need all my kids. Come on, because it's crazy. You know one thing. You know one thing that my auntie used to say when we was kids. She'd be like, "My crew, let's go." That's something I would always tell my kids. My crew, let's go. Come on, because people up in here acting like they ain't got no sense. My crew, let's go. That's how God was really telling us. God was really saying, "Hey, my crew, it's time to roll." Because they done lost their damn mind. Y'all lost y'all mind in Cancer season. Y'all really showed y'all ass in Cancer season. Y'all showed that y'all would sacrifice a baby, a woman, a man, yourself. you will sacrifice anything for your benefit. And that in itself goes to show that the devil can use you as a host. That is preposterous.
It's not surprising that a black woman believes in God since she don't got a dad to believe in.
Ooh. Good thing I have a father and a grandfather. Oh, Lord. That, let me find out the devil got you too. Woo! Heavenly Father above. Anywho, good Lord Almighty. Talking about you don't have a father. Are you crazy? Jesus prays for his disciples. Let's bow your head. Praise your head. My ancestors had your grandfather as well. Oh, I feel like Regina. I don't want to do a show with you no more. You're disrespectful. I don't want to do a show with you no more. You're disrespectful. Jesus prays for his disciples. After Jesus finished saying this and he looked up to the heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Why the fuck? It's 333 likes in here, right? Y'all see how the devil just tried to come up here and bother us. Get your ass on somewhere. Told y'all, I'm just going to block the shit out you with that devilish shit. The hour has come. And the fact that it's after 1 o'clock and today will be considered a new day. The hour has come. Right, the distractions. Jesus Christ, like, child, find you something safe to do. Give glory to your son so that the son may give glory to you. For you gave him authority over all people. That's the emperor energy. So that he might give eternal life to those you gave, for all those you gave him. And eternal life, and that word eternal keeps coming up. And eternal life means to know the only true God and to know Jesus Christ and who sent you. I have shown your glory on earth. I have finished the work you have done to me. Father, give me glory in your presence now, the same glory I had with you before the world was made. I have made you known to those you gave me out of the world. They belong to you and you gave them to me. They have obeyed your word and now they know that everything you gave me comes from you. I gave them the message that you gave me and they received it. They know it is true that I came from you. And they believe you sent me. I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for those you gave me, for they belong to you. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. And my glory is shown through them. And now I am coming to you. I am no longer in the world, and they are in the world. Holy Father, keep them safe by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so that they may be one, just as you and I are one. Union. While I was with them, I kept them safe by the power of my name. This is when I'm telling y'all, Libra season is that kid energy of where they're guiding you. And I told y'all that everybody from past lives and shit like that is trying to come back on some weird shit. You know what I'm saying? It's just some weird shit. And that that ancestral energy and shit. See, you talking about how you had my grandfather, your ancestors had my grandfather. Your ancestors is the same ancestors that's getting their ass tore up, okay? Because that is what's going on in our world. This past life energy that a lot of y'all have been blocked. Y'all were chosen. You were chosen to do this. It's not that you were chosen to, you know what I'm saying, that you was chosen to damn near be the high priestess and shit like that. They ain't got nothing to do with you. You were chosen to conquer a lot of the task and the lessons and the shit that other people in your bloodline couldn't. So now that you were chosen, and it says right here that I keep them safe by the power of my name that you gave me. I protected them. This Libra season gives me that all this protection is happening so you can have fun, Libra season. Because I'm telling y'all, when Scorpio season gets here, that is when your higher self comes. That is when you really step into the limelight. Scorpio season is when the limelight will be happening. Because the way the veil will be very thin starting Halloween, and I'm not going to go into the 25th and the full moon and the new moon because they clearly do not want me to talk about that. But I'm just letting y'all know when Scorpio season gets here, that is going to be your higher self. You've gone through the muggle. You've gone through the inner child. Now you need to really have an open arms to this higher self thing and your higher consciousness. It comes from a godly thing. God consciousness, not cockiness, godliness. It's the form of you that the Lord sees you as. Pay attention. Pay attention. You've been protected this whole time. You do have to realize that the Lord cannot Jesus cannot hold your hand all the time, okay? I've protected them and not one of them was lost, except the man who was bound to be lost. I protected them and the man that, and not one of them was lost, except the man who was bound to be lost. You chose that shit. It was bound to happen for that shit to catch up with your dumb ass. So therefore, you got lost on your own so that the scripture might come true. And now I am coming to you and I say these things in the world so that they may have the joy in their hearts in all its fullness. I gave them your message and the world hated them because they do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. I do not ask you to take them out of the world, but I do ask you to keep them safe from the evil one. I do not ask that you take them out this world, but just protect them from the evil one. Okay, pay attention. Just as I do not belong to the world, they do not belong to the world. Dedicate them to yourself by the means of the truth. Your word is truth. Your word is bond. I told them in that Libra message that this was all going to be about your face card. Your face card spiritually. Your face card in real life, integrity. You're not built like that. You don't have no good heart and good intent. Your face card is trash in these streets, for real. I sent them into the world just as you sent me into the world. And for their sake, I dedicate myself to you in order that they too may be truly dedicated to you. I pray not only for them, but also for those who believe in me because of their message. I pray that they may all be one, Father. May they be in just as you are in me and I am in you. May they be one so that the world will believe that you sent me. I gave them the same glory you gave me, and so that they may be one just as you are one. I am them, I am them, you and me, so that they may be completely one and in order. This is the Three of Pentacles energy. This is what Scorpio season will end off of. It's Scorpio season, but this is what we'll end off of. This is where you'll end up on the 31st of October. When the 10th happens, when 10-10 happens, that'll be you crossing the threshold for your bloodline or whatever. And you'll release a lot of karmic shit or whatever to bring you more closer into the Three of Pentacles. Because, see, the Three of Pentacles energy, like, every part of the pentacle don't all come from you specifically. I told you, some of this shit don't got nothing to do with you. Like, some of the trauma that you fought and shit, it don't got nothing to do with you. Some of the problems that you had financially and all that shit, it don't got nothing to do with you. A lot of y'all financially, like, if you want me to be real with y'all, a lot of y'all financially have issues that have nothing to do with you. You just happen to inherit that type of bullshit. A lot of you guys have been stolen from for generations and generations and generations and generations. And every single generation that they try to give the person in that generation or in that bloodline a chance to get that inheritance, they fuck it up. They take the easy way out. So God be like, yeah, my boy, you're not really doing according to the plan. So we're just going to go ahead and skip to the next blood person because, see, you're not built for that. You're not built for that. You're not trying to be union with the Lord and you're not trying to be tapped in. You know what I'm saying? Like, lock in for a tweak out. God tweaked out on them. Okay. God tweaked out on them. They wasn't built for that. And some of you guys, you were the one to say, all right, look, man, look. You was like, Sheila, and when, how to get with me, I don't know how I'm going to get up this mountain, but I'm going to get up this mountain to save my marriage. And that's what a lot of y'all did. And due to the fact that a lot of y'all did that, not only are you getting, you're not getting the repercussions, not the repercussions, the reparations for you. You're getting the reparations for you and all of them because you was the one to actually stand 10 toes down about yourself. So they couldn't stand 10 toes down by themselves. That's why they ain't getting no money. And so, you know, that's why they work. And that's why a lot of y'all don't work. And, you know, you're supposed to do your purpose and your North Node. And that's why a lot of you guys will understand when I tell y'all that the Lord pays my bills. See, when I tell people that, they always think I'm trying to be funny and cover up some funny shit that I'm doing. But I'd be dead serious. I'm not sure why people think that's a joke and shit. But see, now I see what Jesus was talking about when Jesus told them certain things. And they was like, well, let us see proof. What the fuck proof you need to see? The Lord give me the money and I pay the damn bill. What the hell? The Lord tell me to do this and it happened. So I don't know. I just follow what the Lord told me to do. You know what I'm saying? Some of us is on Jesus payroll. You know, some of us is at the Christian Credit Union. I mean, not all of us are at the Christian Credit Union. You know, not all of us are members of the Christian Credit Union, okay? You know, that's just, you know, you got to be a member of the Christian Credit Union. I don't know what to tell you, sweetheart. You know, CCU for death, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know what to tell you, okay? And now I see what Jesus was talking about. So he said, Father, you have given them to me and I want them to be with me where I am so that they may see my glory and the glory you gave me. For you loved me before the Lord was made. Righteous Father, the world does not know you, but I know you. And these know that you sent me. And these know that you sent me. I made you known to them. And I will continue to do so in order that the love you have for me may be in them so that they may also be in them. So that I also may be in them. My bad. The arrest of Jesus. This is when they arrested Jesus. This is when they arrested Jesus. The empty tomb. This is when Jesus arises from the tomb. We ain't even going to go deep up in John because John got a lot of chapters. But I'm just saying. That was everything I just explained. And then, you remember when Jesus was taken to the tomb, when Jesus was crucified, and they said in 3 days he will risen. They was like, he will rise. And then, it's funny, when he rose, everybody else, only certain people saw Jesus, and the ones that saw Jesus is the ones that believed him. This is the pre-story. You know, they always say the prequel or the prequel. I don't know. Whatever one of the movies that, like, when it means, what do you mean by that? Prequel, yeah. This was the prequel. You know how sometimes, like, you ever hear a story and they tell you, like, how we got here? Like, y'all know that TikTok that would be like, this is me. This is me. And this is how we got here. That's what I feel like that just was. Thank you for confirmation. This is the prequel. This is just like that TikTok where he's like, this is me. Let me show you how we got here. This is how a lot of y'all about to have the testimony of how you got here. Oh my gosh. This is the start of where you can start telling people, this is me and this is how I got here. That's crazy. That's fucking crazy. The devil. What did I tell you about the devil? What did I tell you about the devil? But it's not the devil. I'm sorry. It's Capricorn. I told you. It's Capricorn. It's Saturn. Capricorns are calling. Capricorns are calling. The high priest is the intuition, the spirit of Jesus, the prequel of how you got here, the wheel of fortune, the ten of pentacles. Come on. Come on. You can't make that up. I can hear that TikTok. This is me. And you're probably wondering how I got here. I can hear it in my head. Well, this is me. He doesn't give birth, nor is he born. So the father-son doesn't really make sense. Okay, Malik, you go ahead and argue the Bible with somebody else, okay? Toodles. Just read the damn Bible. And you over here trying to argue with me about the Bible. Get your ass on, son. See, two of pentacles. I'm telling you, I can just hear this energy of, this is me. You're probably wondering how I got into this situation. You're probably wondering how I got into this situation. Look at this shit. Hangman, the two of wands, a choice. Eight of Pentacles and a Knight of Pentacles. You worked on this and it took time. This was the stability, I'm telling. And they keep, I don't hate it, God. It's not that I hate it. But it's playing in my head really loud. Like, you're probably wondering how I got here. Like, it's loud. Like, it's really loud in my head right now. Like, it's extreme. Look, the Page of Pentacles and the Ace of Cups. Oh my gosh. 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 Boy, 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 did we go down a motherfucking rabbit hole? Did we go down a motherfucking rabbit hole tonight? Did we go down a motherfucking rabbit hole tonight? I told y'all when I sparked that blunt, it'd be something. I told y'all when I sparked that blunt, it'd be something. I feel like Lil Wayne when he be in the studio and he clicked that damn lighter. You know the verse finna be fire when he clicked the lighter. That's exactly how I feel when I just lit that bitch. Cause as soon as I started smoking, I was like, I'm on to something. Hold on. And then I started getting too deep into it. Y'all know I be real nosy. And they was like, you too deep into it. Adjustment. Looking back, moving forward. Okay, what's next? But this is that movement forward that we talked about earlier, the Eight of Cups. I think it's time to write that book now, huh? You know, that makes me think of Waukesha. He was like, Alexa, play Waukesha by Moneybagg Yo.
Waukesha by Moneybagg Yo on Amazon Music.
Waukesha, bitch, Waukesha.
But honestly, it ain't nobody's business what's in my carcass and your carcass and that cup. It's your cup. Drink it. So whatever the hell was in my cup, the only reaction I did was got more popular, more successful, did a lot more things than I've ever done. I probably should pick that cup back up.
I'm sitting here looking at Keisha like, do you love me, do you?
Alexa, pause the music. That's exactly what I just heard in my head. I think I should pick that cup back up. Anything else? Fucking knew it. Look at this shit, y'all. Adjustment, right? Looking back, moving forward, right? We just said the Eight of Cups to the Six of Cups, walking away from the past, right? Then we got darkness to light. We just read in the Bible about the darkness to light, right? And then you get on the illuminated path, but the illuminated path comes from what? A path from what the Lord sees you as. And this is all priestess energy. This is all that energy of the feminine energy I've been trying to tell you. Power over difficulty. Because it's about to be what? Power over popularity. You ain't built like that. You really not that girl. Reclaiming your power. Clairvoyance. Inspiration. Interpretation. Trust. This is the lady that gets the messages from the Lord. And she waits to interpret them. And then she makes moves. Well, that'll do it. That will do it. That'll do it. Y'all. All right. Power over difficulty. This card brings you a warning that these are situations, people, or patterns in your life threatening to take over. The snake can be venomous, tempting, or even strangling. This card is an important reminder to be honest with yourself and investigate your relationships and your daily tasks to determine what may be harmful or dishonoring to you or even be consuming you. If someone is bringing toxic energy into your life, it may be necessary to let that person go or at least reduce your exposure dramatically. If a situation seems to be suffocating you or sapping your sense of freedom, and enthusiasm, it's time to rethink your motivation for remaining engaged. If you're feeling a building of resentment for a job, that energy of resentment, like I told you, or a personal task, this card is telling you to learn how to bring more conscious joy to the experience or to even exit it altogether. Also, be mindful of all your own personal patterns. Consider the causes of your making and the results they're creating. You do not want to become the snake that eats up its own tail, consuming your own life force and sabotaging your own desire to move forward. The adjustments. Yet always remember the indomitable strength of your inner spirit and true life force represented here by the swans. And swans, what do swans signify? The swan's spiritual meaning is grace, beauty, love, trust, and loyalty. Swan symbolism is also linked into inner beauty and self-love. A pair of swans represents soulmates for life. But fuck the soulmates for life. It represents inner beauty and self-love. Who, in spite of their gentle beauty, are very powerful creatures, capable of striking anything that attacks. You have that power as well. And this card is telling you to strike out at your own self-sabotaging patterns and to break free from any other limiting influences holding you down. Become conscious and courageous in your ongoing choices, and you have the power now. The affirmation here says, I release toxic people and patterns from my life. I empower myself in choices and in my relationships. And I told y'all that with Pluto, you need to let go of all them addictions and weird shit like that. Checkmate. Checkmate. Hold on. Wait. Not the fucking priest of wisdom. I know you fucking lying. It says the priestess of wisdom pauses and looks over her shoulder as she receives owl guidance about adjustments to make before moving forward. The high priestess that just came out. Mm-hmm. Yes, Lord. And the queen of pentacles, like I told y'all in my podcast. Go listen to my podcast. Especially tomorrow while y'all doing what y'all doing at work or some shit. Go listen to it. When this card appears in your spread, pay attention to the cards placed on either side. For this represents issues you need to be considering now. The first card that came after this is death and rebirth, darkness to light. And didn't I tell y'all when Pluto goes direct that things, the truth was going to be brought to light? This card marks a pause in your energy and a time to contemplate what you've been doing and to determine if any changes would prove beneficial. Reflection and course correction is now are wiser than charging full stream ahead. The owl has extraordinary vision and can adjust to its focus from the telescopic or microscopic in an instant. In fact, it is always adjusting and always ready to redirect its path for a more effective result. This card is suggesting that you should do the same. Review your previous choices to determine what has worked for you. Look ahead to see what changes can accelerate your plans for wishing. And the full moon is in fucking Aries coming up. This call for some patience and courage, for you may have to shift or even abandon the path that has been your primary focus. But take note to the bright light from the right, the future pouring into the priestess of wisdom's left hand, receiving knowledge, downloads, the crown chakra. Because Libra season is the third eye, the sacral chakra, and the fucking root chakra. So as you're seeing things from a higher perspective, which will indicate the owl, you then can allow downloads to process differently when it comes to the throat. So how you speak on it, you watch who you speak to, you watch what you say, and you watch what you speak on it, okay? Then it goes down to the heart. So you feel that this is a great opportunity for you. It goes to the solar plexus chakra. You have a sense of confidence about what you feel and what you've seen from a higher perspective. So therefore, you have a sense of faith, a sense of determination, discipline. So then it goes to the sacral chakra of your creative energy of how can you create a space of peace for this idea that has come down, and what emotion does it trigger? And then you can move on the root chakra of stability of where you can find stableness. as well as the orbs around her. You know, as well as the orbs there and at her third eye. She is guided, and she is guided in the next card after death and rebirth was guided path, the illuminated path. She is guided in her adjustments by the clarity and vision of the owl, as a well-being is directed into the future by light in the orbs of the spiritual world. You too can be so guided when you let yourself stop, reconsider, adjust, and move peacefully forward with trust. Her eyes are closed. The spirit animal's there. The illuminated path guide. She uses her left hand to guide her. Her intuition. And the fact that the death and the rebirth card is number 19, which equals up to 10, is giving me the energy between now and 10-10. This card indicates a time of closure and great transition at hand. This may seem relatively minor, an event or something big like an ending of a relationship, a job, or a longtime residence. Remember, however, that this card signifies important change. And then, you know what was crazy? I could have sworn I had... Hold on. What angel number was it? Hold on. And then the word that I received during my podcast was adaptability, change. Yes. So today I was sitting in, what the fuck was that? Today I was sitting in, I was just sitting down minding my business or whatever, and I got up for notification at 2:25, and I was like, damn, I wonder what 2:25 means. 2:25 is a message that says adaptability, and this is where I got the word adaptability, as I had just posted my podcast at 2:22, and as I was sitting there after I posted the podcast, a notification came up at 2:25, and I was like, fuck the notification, what 2:25 mean? And it says adaptability will be needed because major changes in your life are coming. Take these changes in stride and grace and move things around to make room for those changes. This can include moving houses or changing career. Come on now. Even out of the most difficult experience or the deepest darkness comes a new life filled with light and unexpected blessings. What did Jesus say in the Bible today in John about that? About bringing the blessings? The Black Panther is a symbol of power through transformation. Although the Panthers are intense. This is Scorpio. This is Pluto. Although the Panthers here are intense, they bring the mystical message that you have the power. As we literally get power over difficulty, reclaiming your power, you have the power to let go of fear of the unknown. And when you do so, you will come out of the darkness. You make the adjustment. You go through the death and the rebirth, and then you touch the illuminated path. You have the power to let go of fear of the unknown. And then I said that in my podcast the other day or whatever. And I was like, a lot of you guys just need to get comfortable with the unknown. And I think it was when I said, get your act together, that I did on the 17th. When the September 17th came, a big shift happened that day too, energetically. When you do so, you will come out of the darkness enlightened. We got the hangman. I need to save part of this live. How long have I been alive? Ooh, maybe not. If you're here, you're just here. And if you're not, oh, well. Okay. Enlighten and wake up to a newly conscious life. The Panther's priestess dressed in white. Hold on. Because what are we dressed in? Okay. Okay, I told y'all the Lord told me to wear all white tonight. Dressed in white comes to tame the difficult energies within this transition. She carries antlers, totems, icon of clear perception. She directs you to open your awareness to new opportunities amongst your way. The anarchy people, I told you, I come from them anarchy people. And that was the light codes that I was giving y'all because of the karmic cycle that you guys are closing. The anarchy people give you new information. You've done nothing but see receive an energetic shift and new information on this damn call we've been on. We on FaceTime. You've been on FaceTime with me leveling up, okay? Glory to God. Any change that may present itself should be considered from a spiritual point of view. Look within. Whether you're dealing with the lost job or the shifting or ending of a relationship, there's a deeper message in the lesson. What did I say earlier about the lessons? The blessing was a lesson. Sometimes you just got to see it through. Trust in yourself and in your future, for you are stronger and more resourceful than you realize. Your personal power is charged with the energy of your eternal spirit. The Lord, the Jesus said in the Bible about the eternal life, it will light the darkness and carry you forward into a truly wonderful new life. The affirmation here says, I turn my eternal soul for power and direction. I fearlessly face the future. That's the prequel. Y'all already went through that. That's already happened. That's what's coming out. That's the darkness we're coming out of. Ooh, look. Hidden knowledge, Akashic records, silent understanding. But no, that's the energy we coming out of. We're not going into that shit. We coming out that shit. Why Pluto was in retrograde the last 5 months, that's what that was all about. The darkness. Y'all ain't see all that dark energy we was going through? Pluto is the planet of transportation. Transformation and deep wounds. Deep wounds. The devilish energy is always in the deepest wounds. So you've released that. We released that. We passed that now. That's done. That's been completed. We checked that box off now. So, that's fucking crazy. My candle's going crazy right now. I feel like they waving at me like, they like, you doing it. You know what I feel? Y'all know at the end of the door when they be like, we did it. Yay, Loisimo. We did it. That's crazy. That's fucking crazy. I keep hearing that fucking TikTok in my head over and 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 over again. That's crazy. That's fucking crazy. And you know, I hear that TikTok in both ways. Cause you know, some people they be going through shit. Like they be, you know what I'm saying? Like they fell or some shit like that. Like, or like, you know what I'm saying? Like something bad happens to them. They be like, you probably wonder how I got here. Like it's both energies for some reason to me. Not everybody's, you're wondering how I got here is a good, you wonder why I got here. Some people's just like a, how did you get there? What were you doing? Oh, God, that's not safe. I don't know. If anybody wants a personal reading before I go, let me know. Because that was crazy. That was crazy. That was crazy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, K. Ross. And I bought 10 of these. I remember buying 10 of these. They were buy one, get one free. Oh, shit. That's crazy. I remember I'm over here drinking the water, not even thinking of it. And then I look, I'm like, and I'm telling you, I bought 10 of these. That's crazy. We literally just got done talking about Eternal, and then I pick up Eternal water. That's crazy. That's fucking crazy. That's fucking crazy, man. I'm telling y'all. Sometimes I just know people wouldn't believe me about my life and shit. You know what I'm saying? They wouldn't believe the shit that I be going through. Excuse me. They just wouldn't believe me. People would really be like, And I'd be like, I be going through a fucking lot. Like, my life be crazy, bro. Like, the stuff that I be going through and be, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's crazy. We literally just talk. And then I told y'all that water is one of the most important elements in the world. My ears itching like a motherfucker. Let's talk about it. You trying to be my friend? Or you trying to be my business? You trying to be my friend, trying to be my business. You know what I mean? I just feel like PR means personal reading. Y'all be so cute. Y'all be trying to kick it. You my brother? Okay. I'm tired. I'm tired. I feel like we just went down a rabbit hole. Y'all know what I'm tired of, and y'all know I'm not no hating ass bitch. But I am so tired of seeing bitches shake their ass on TikTok. Like, I feel like every TikTok that they make got their ass going crazy. I'm so tired of that. But that's just my opinion. Don't get me wrong. You know, somebody was like, they finna get the fuck up off this app. Somebody said, I'm finna get the fuck up off this app. The Instagram girls done found out where we at and they trying to take over. They won't last for long. You know why they won't last for long? Like, you know what I'm saying? I might do a little, you know what I'm saying? I might do a little thug dizzle, you know what I'm saying? But I'm not finna just be, like, strictly up here shaking ass. Like, come on now. You don't got nothing else? Come on, let's get somebody else we can learn something from. Let's get somebody here we can learn something from. Like, the fuck? Let's get somebody here we can learn something from. Because God bless. Tired of seeing it. I respect it. I really do. I just feel like they really trying to make this, like, let me be quiet. Because y'all know I take the ass out. I know I be taking folks out on TikTok. Let me be quiet. The Lord says, it's all right. You know, somebody is going through this damn tornado hurricane and they are in a floating pool. I told y'all, get y'all asses out them fucking states.
I just want to say, if you've ever floated in a floaty pool in your own living room with your refrigerator, your door...
I told y'all, get out them fucking stays, bro. The damn lady is in the damn, she is damn in a floaty pool in her living room.
I just want to say, if you've ever floated in a floaty pool in your own living room with your refrigerator, your door, I just want to say,
the damn lady is in a pool. I told them, folks, get out them fucking states, bro. Please, Jesus, please. Like, I get it. You know what I'm saying? I really do. I understand what y'all going through. You know, I don't. Let me stop. I don't. Because I'm trying to tell you, I am an evacuating type of bitch. I got to go. You know what I'm saying? Like, what the world going on? I can't deal with stuff like that. Like, y'all don't understand, Mother Nature is not, she don't have no patience. You see what I'm saying? She don't got no patience for ignorance. You know what I'm saying? She don't have no patience. And people like, and I get it, you know what I'm saying? You from there, so you like, shit, you know what I'm saying? I could swim and one body amongst nature? You really want to take your odds against nature? Like, that shit just be blowing me. Good night. That shit be blowing me. Like, you really want to play your odds against nature. Nature. I don't like that. I don't like that. Something about that make my head hurt. I don't like that. I don't really like that people like to play with their odds against nature. Like, what is it about your home that you must stay in that home against nature? Like, do y'all remember when Texas was flooding and that boy came downstairs in his loft apartment and the whole damn bottom of the apartment was floating in water? Like, you know what I'm saying? People that had alligators in their house because the alligator